Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Lost Run here in the Binding of Isaac Repentance series. We're on day number 2 of the Lost Week. Oh boy. I mean, we got through yesterday without having to need an extra life, so hopefully we can keep on going here. I feel a little bit better about today, though, because we did get another video that crossed 3,000 likes. Thank you all very much for making that possible. Y'all are giving me strength to get through this week and get on to the next like streak goal, and I appreciate that. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by OKTel1024. Title Throw is my second time trying digital art. Thanks for always making my day sin. Thank you very much, OKTel. Going back with the old school logo there, too. I kind of like it. It's like a fusion of the old and the new. All right, here we go. Round number 2 of the Lost. Let's see if we get some. Let's see if we get a banger. Oh no, it's Curse of the Unknown. Charlie Papa Hotel Echo 37 Kilo Romeo. I should mention really quickly here, just at the start of this episode, I'm expecting a phone call from the doctor. So if I get that, I may have to pause the video, but I'll give everyone the heads up before that happens. So yeah. Bloody Lust does literally nothing for us, as it is only activated by us taking damage. And yeah, if we take damage, I don't know if you knew this or not. Have you heard about this? Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? We die because we are the Lost. So that is the reason why Curse of the Unknown does not matter, because, well, we don't have any HP, dog. We got no HP, dog. Take the Rusted Key, which might increase the chance of us getting some keys every now and then. Again, fully exploiting our strength, us having flying as well as Spectral Tears. Okay. Justice. I mean, the Justice card might help us out. We could maybe find a secret room that has a reroll machine in it and then maybe get lucky and spawn a reroll pedestal. I am going to go back and reroll Scapegoat, because as you saw on yesterday's video, I mean, the Lost he is a character that you just need to get every single advantage that you can get. So obviously we're not going to get any HP here, but we are going to gain some damage, and that's something that we were kind of lacking yesterday up towards the second half of the run, I would say. So having early damage is going to be very important for us, and utilizing every ounce of strength that we can. I actually meant to go pick up that Empress card to use it here. That would have been kind of a big help. And this is not an easy fight. I mean, Old Dookie, how many times have you seen us get clipped by, if not Old Dookie, then by the flies that he kind of like extends out and stuff. So, you know, again, we got to be careful here. Movement speed, of course, is also very important on the Lost. You want to make sure that you're maneuverable. You want to make sure that you have the ability to get out of the way of stuff. And just overall, just to keep your distance. That's another aspect about Isaac that kind of gets lost in the sauce, is that there's no reason to get point blank. Even right now, I'm getting a little bit too close to the Duke, when we have plenty of range to be able to facilitate us just sitting back towards the, you know, our backs against the wall and basically just plucking away at him. That's a much safer route to go. Yeah, PJs, don't do it for us. They give us no stat gains that we need. So there's again, no reason for us to go over there. So I am going to reroll with the Eternal D6. Hopefully it doesn't proc, and we actually get something other than HP. We do get ourselves a nickel, so it was a nice little bonus. Unfortunately, though, we are not going to be able to get the map. Man, that would really help a lot if we can get the treasure map. I don't think it's going to happen. Reroll the boss item, and I'm down with that. Here we go, day 2. Alrighty, so we've got ourselves some early building power here. Latchkey is good normally, I don't value Latchkey very high right now. I mean, yes, we do need keys, because obviously we have this Justice card. However, is Latchkey really worth jeopardizing everything, especially before this first boss here on the second floor? I'm going to say no. I think we can jolly well wait for that to happen. Hopefully we can gain basically the only reason why I'd be going for Latchkey is not for the luck upgrade, but because we want to have the two keys. That's the only reason why I would ever go for that. And then if you sort of compartmentalize it in that sense and distill it down to it's just a couple of keys, are two keys worth going up against two bosses for as the Lost? And the answer is an emphatic no, in my opinion. We might could use a bomb there. We might could use a bomb. Right now, I'm going to choose not to, and we get nothing. So the sneeze may have actually been okay for the lost. Okay. I'm going to go for it because it might give us... Yeah, there we go. That's exactly what I was looking for. Okay, so now we have the ability to get into the secret room, which is right here, and still have enough to buy another bomb if we need it. Fool card. The fool card's okay if you have a reroll pedestal, which we don't. I could also, in a pinch... Yeah, that's what I was kind of afraid of. In a pinch, I was going to say I could drop down the justice card and maybe, maybe get... some help here. Now, obviously, we're gonna go with Keeper Sack. Keeper Sack could be huge for us. And on top of that, we get to reroll these pedestals in here as well. So, you know, this could be pretty big. And we at least can buy this key and then open up the other stuff. So, reroll it. Look at that. We get a free options. It's good. Keeper Sack's gonna give us a 0.62 damage upgrade. That is absolutely, positively incredible. Hangman card. Needless to say, the hangman card is probably not going to matter since we already have flying. Yeah. But Keeper Sack, obviously, big-time play is going to give us all those stats that we need and then some. You know, getting options for free, essentially, thanks to Diplopia and the Eternal D-Sizzle. That's huge. These are the kind of plays that you have to make on characters like The Lost, like Tainted Jacob, like Tainted Lazarus, like Tainted Lost, to really succeed. You're going to find yourself, if you start thinking, like, how can we get, what is the best possible route for the most amount of items? If you start thinking like that, you're going to be winning in Isaac. And this is a just sad, pathetic devil deal. Now, what sucks is that we don't have a full chart, so I can't even reroll these. So we have to hope that the devil deal stays open, which it did. Okay. All right. Might be some hope for us. Have ourselves a full charge here and pray for the best. We could go reroll latchkey. I still don't think I can't justify it for two keys. Like, yes, you do gain the luck upgrade, but, like, at what price, basically? And the price is possibly, like, the run, like, losing. So. Very happy to see Speedball there. It's a very nice... little movement speed upgrade that we got with the shot speed upgrade. Shot speed upgrade to boot. There you go. Look at that. We didn't have to kill a bunch of bosses just to get those keys, so. There we go. Can we bomb our way in there? No, we cannot. Keeping this poop around is important because you need to have some kind of obstruction to stop the Globins from getting too close to you. They can run you over very quickly in this room as well. We didn't have flying. We're super toast in this room. All right, got the champion down. If you can take down one of the toxic spewers, then the rest of the room falls pretty easily. Yeah, this is a great room for us. We have flying, so we don't have to worry about needing stuff to. Oh, there's a charge key. Get those. I think we go a little brimmy. Now, I know that the play looks like we need to take pay to play, but it is not a good option when it comes to Keeper Sack. The reason being is because you need to have as much money as possible with Keeper Sack, and every single golden chest that is going to come our way, every single door, everything is going to require money, and we just don't want... We want our money to go into buying stuff in the shop, just so we can give us more and more stats. That's the only thing that matters here. I'm actually really surprised that the shot actually hit us there. Seagram should be here. I mean, I really want to re-roll this, but Glitch Crown offers us a very high chance of getting something monstrous out of this, so I think we just gotta. I don't like Glitch Crown. I think people are just trolling me at this point when I say that, like, you know, I don't want to do the whole, like, I'll just hit the escape menu and then it pauses for you. Yeah, I don't want to do that. Just like I don't want to exploit, like, portals for the infinite HP on like crawl spaces and whatnot, or IV bags and stuff. Like, I don't want to play like that. I want to try to test my might, test my skill. So the Glitch Crown is going to make every single item pedestal that we get rotate between like 7 items or something like that. Something ridiculous. Oh, I saw that little bounce against the wall. Sad bomb, we gotta be careful. Perfection, and we want Cat of Nine Tails here. Wooden Spoon wouldn't be so bad either, but Cat of Nine Tails is like, you know, Cat of Nine Tails is Cat of Nine Tails. I will take Perfection. We could go back and buy something in the store. We can buy that sack, I guess. We're making good progress for Boss Rush, though, and Boss Rush is actually kind of important now that we have Glitch Crown. Here we go. We don't want the coupon. We do want jumper cables, though. That's going to give us a 0.48 damage up, and I'm fine with that. We will buy this bomb as well. Look at that, another 0.43 damage up. It's just so dang good. So dang good. Oh, perfect timing. Doctor is calling, so you're going to see a brief pause, everybody. Actually, you're not going to see anything, but I'm going to pause. All right, sorry about that. Oh, man. The idea here is, again, just to keep feeding ourselves as much currency as possible while we try to get as many stats as we possibly can with Keeper Sack, prioritizing anything that's going to give us any money. Ooh, come on now. I think we go Binky here. This is a tough choice, though, because we got to fight 2 bosses, remember. But Binky is a significant tiers up and a big DPS up for us, so we just got to play it safe. Again, talking what I was talking about, going up against old Dookie, just utilize range. Range is going to be your best friend on top of having flight. Okay, let's not start doing that here, game. I do not want to use our bombs here against Carrion Queen unless we absolutely have to. This is where Lil Brimmy is really going to help us out with the piercing. As long as we can dodge the red poops, we cannot really reliably stand on top of the spikes, as she will basically clip into the spikes. So just trying to line her up as best as I can here with a little brimstone, and this is going to be a big help towards securing ourselves some better DPS with the tiers up that we got from Binky. The size down also kind of helps out a little bit. She is not bouncing in a way that I'm liking here. All right, so we got a Tears up. It's very good. And Little Brimstone really just provides us with, again, those piercing shots, but also supplementary damage towards our towards the initial target. I am going to go with the counterfeit penny as for the aforementioned stuff that we just got done talking about. You know, needing to have ourselves a good economy, making sure that we're getting as much money as possible so we can convert that into stats. So normally I would try to bisect these fires here. Oh, baby. This is imperative here. We get 9 lives. There we go. All right. We can breathe a little bit of relief now. It's still going to be my purpose and my aim and goal not to use any lives here, but it is nice knowing that we do have a little bit of insurance. And that's basically what you want to look out for. And honestly, credit goes to Glitch Crown. I mean, I take flack for saying that I'm not a huge fan of Glitch Crown. It is it's an annoying item, but it is undoubtedly helpful. It's just annoying whenever if you miss an item, or you know, if you end up inadvertently taking a bad item, that's when it can be frustrating. But undoubtedly and unequivocally, it is a good item for us on any run. Again, I want to clear up any misconception when I talk about Glitch Crown, because people seem to think that I hate the item. I don't hate the item. I think that it is just an annoying item to play with, but it is good. There's no downside to it other than it possibly erasing an item that you may have taken just because your timing was off or whatever. But you know, Glitch Crown giving us the opportunity in there. Also, of course, the decision making to go into the curse room as a lost. It can be a little bit scary. You know, the lost is not a character that you can really afford to take a lot of gambling on. But when it does pay off, you know, it goes well. So this is going to be a huge help for us if we can manage to get some payouts here. And you know what? Cardio Coin, you're playing a little bit. You're playing too close to the fire there for my liking. 2 bombs here. Obviously, we do not need the prayer bead. Oh, man. C-section or Proptosis. I think we go C-section here. Yeah. C-section is a powerful tool. And, you know, giving us that homing, giving us that really, really powerful range that we want and we need. You know, this is starting to look good. This is starting to look like a run that we can make and turn into something real fun and not stressful. Obviously, we want to go deep pockets here. Pocket's going to allow us to take even more items via the shops, and we can start balling out of control. We can rest easy here on a Tuesday. You know, it feels liberating not to have to worry too much about being bound by the stress of playing as the lost, and you know, not overthinking. And that's really, again, something I talked about on day one. Don't overthink stuff. Don't overthink. It's still, at the end of the day, it's still Isaac. You still got to play good. You have to play to your fundamentals. Make sure you're not making dumb moves. Make sure you're not making dumb decisions. Oh, man. You know that we're going to go for the Spirit Sword here. You know we're going Spirit Sword. We might as well go for the Angel Deal, too, here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's time. Okay. We might even go see Lamb and do a victory lap here. A Spirit Sword and C-section just remain one of the most powerful combos that you can get. Just by themselves. I mean, the fact that they deal so much damage, and of course Spirit Sword scales so well with damage upgrades. On top of that, they deal the C-section damage of the contact damage. So it's like it's everything that you want in burst damage, but also sustained damage. It is a perfect combo. All we're really missing now is gonna be like Eye of Belial and like, you know, Soy Milk or something, or even if we get Polyphemus or like Tech X or something. That would be even more incredibler. And we also have a chance of actually getting boss rush here if we make a very mad dash towards the shop as well as the item room, which is not over here. Look at that, just chopping them down. Deep pockets feeding us some money. That's going to lead to more stats for us. You love it. You see it. Blue map looks good to me. Or BOGO bombs, I guess, and BFF for sure. There we go. Getting more movement speed, getting more, just more raw damage is just wonderful. And, you know, this is another factor that leads into playing the Lost, but also into just Isaac in general, is just how much general knowledge do you have, you know, of the items, of the strategies that you can employ, I should say. All that stuff is deeply, deeply valuable when it comes to these clutch situations where you have to make, you know, basically run-defying decisions. Like, do we want to take C-section? Do we think that we can play to our strengths? Do we think that we're going to be able to be safe? Would this jeopardize our position as the Lost without 9 lives? That sort of thing. So, and yes, this is a bona fide, genuine Sinvicta full clear right here. I think Tech Zero would have been nice, but apparently that's just not going to be in the cards, and yeah. All right. And that's where Glitch Crown kind of fails a little bit, but, you know, we can debate all you want about, you know, whose fault is it really whenever you fail Glitch Crown. Is it Glitch Crown's fault, or is it, like, you know, the user? Of course, 100% of the time it's the user. It's never the game's fault. The game is blameless. It's innocent. A hapless victim in a world of complaining. I'm gonna go squeezy here if I can. Getting maxed out tiers with C-section is going to be very, very vital to getting more babies out. So we are not gonna make boss rush, which is unfortunate, but also not that surprising considering how long floor 4 was. And it paid off, obviously, because us getting 9 lives, us getting C-section, is just going to make our lives a lot easier. It would have been nice to have been able to capitalize on a Glitch Crown with boss rush, but well, sometimes the plan doesn't work out fully, and that's okay. Our last key here. Probably shouldn't have done that. So this is a global D sizzle. So we can reroll what's inside of the boss trap room right now, and we can also reroll something in the item room if we don't like it. 3 more Yaves. The baby's just going out, just going ham. Looking like me with my claw blade and wild heart. Forget me now. We do not want Hamilacria. I'm going to be honest, these kind of suck, and I don't want to use the Eternal D6 because I don't want to consume either of the portals. So we're going to rip the D-Sizzle. Ooh. We do not want Car Battery. We do want Mom's Key, though. We can help it. Although Chaos with Glitch Crown is also kind of pog. I'm going to go Chaos here. Joker, I'm just going to use right now. Yeah, immediately it's a failure on Chaos's part here. I guess we'll take the Intruder. I do want starter deck as well. World card, party time. Excellent. World card. It's party time. Excellent. I mean, I'm down with Shoop. Although Crooked Penny would be quite chaotic. Let's stick with Shoop. We say thank you to the Eternal D-Sizzle for making it happen. And that's also going to get re-rolled by the Global D6 in the four room, so let's go ahead and do that now. And we also have the Soul of Eden, which will also create more pedestals for us to reroll with a Glitch Crown. Or it just turns into the red key and that's it. Guppy's Collar is our second Guppy item. Okay. Let's go see what turned into the boss trap room. Nothing. It stayed exactly the same. Okay, so it's not really worth it for us to reroll stuff with chaos inside of a boss trap room just because we have a perfectly good item pedestal over here that we can reroll anyway. And it should trigger the glitch crown. There we go. Death's Touch would be kind of nice here. It is going to lower our tiers a little bit, but the damage buff that we get is going to be quite nice. For Shoop and for our babies as well. So I need to go back and go get that Fool card. We have starter deck, so there's no reason for us not to. And on top of that, it gives us a little bit more security. If we do end up losing the Holy Mantle, we can teleport out and refresh it and then start the fight over again. I'm not suggesting that's going to happen, of course, because we do have 9 lives plus Guppy's Collar, and our damage is also just kind of wacky right now. So just in case, though, that's just displaying some strats, and we did not get a deal with the Devil or Angel. That's good, because that means we get a guaranteed one on the next floor, even though we have chaos. The reason why chaos is relevant in that discussion is because angel deals and devil deals no longer matter, because everything is homogenized now. So basically whatever items that we get are just going to be from any item pool in the entire game. So it's no longer important for us to even care about angel deals or devil deals. What's more important now is just getting item pedestals. And living and winning, of course. So I did take the negative because I just wanted to. It'd be a nice little challenge for ourselves here to see if we can get through an entire run, including a, curse. Wait. Yeah, I was going to say, hang on a second, we don't have Curse of the Maze. Oh, my pennies, dang it. Anything that's increasing our raw damage is going to be pretty good. Get ourselves a Moon card for the exact same reason why the Fool card is great for us. Same thing goes for the Moon card. So we can refresh our, Holy Mantle. I do not know what Birthright does. Better Destiny. Hang on, I'm going to look this up. I think Birthright for the Lost removes all the low quality items. Birthright. Gotten Lazarus Eden the Lost. Useless items like HP upgrade, spectral tears, or flight are removed from the item pools. But even better items. That's something that should happen regardless, but I mean, the blanket gives us another Holy Mantle charge inside of bosses, so you know, it's just more protection for us. And honestly, the removal of HP and stuff is not going to matter that much. Okay. Notice how they're firing off the Master Sword now? With Godhead? Yeah. This run is getting a little out of control now, I think. Oh man, I had a stressful, you know, it was kind of a stressful weekend with personal stuff going on, and you know, and going into the Lost week, I was like, yeah, you know, I'm a little bit nervous, but I nervous but confident. I'm just, again, not overthinking things, blah blah blah. And then we get gifted this gem. Ooh. I don't actually want Cricket Leg because of the war flies. It is nice to be able to spawn the flies, but remember, we're only one away from Guppy, so... Yeah, get another Fool card here. Did you see that that deflection there by that one baby? That was incredible. The Godhead Tears plus C-section plus Spirit Sword is just... I mean, this is the type of stuff that you dream about on any given Isaac run, let alone a Lost run. Sun card, I figured we were probably going the right way. The Death card. Watch the health just get absolutely cut down. Down goes Mama. I think we'll wait on old Hushy, but maybe on the way back. I'll be honest, I'm not exactly super enthused to go through a death loop against Delirium or old Hushy, even on a run like this. I don't want to ruin the vibe. I don't want to ruin the mojo. I would enjoy some damage up and maybe a little bit more movement speed. Maxing our tiers would also be kind of nice if we could wing it. If not, then it's not that big of a deal game. I don't want to ask for too much. You've already given us so much. Okay. All right. Here we go. But again, this is a run that good decision making and a little bit of luck and a little bit of skill really brought together, you know, with Glitch Crown, the decision to roll stuff instead of take stuff, the decision of, you know, do we want to, in terms of strategy, how much money do we want to go deep? Do we want to take Chaos? You know, Chaos had a big, big, big part in us getting a lot of these items that we're currently enjoying. Same with Glitch Crown, of course. Glitch Crown plus Chaos is not a synergy. It's not a synergy that you really even think of all that much, unless if you just have a lot of experience with the game. Let me go in the curse room. Although it is Curse the Blind, so... Curse the Blind with Glitch Crown and Chaos is a recipe for disaster. Flying makes this room a total joke. Cage didn't even get a chance to do anything there. Money equals power would be a fantastic upgrade for us, obviously. Oh, that sword at the very end. Excuse you. Excuse you, baby. Stanley just getting bullied here. Yeah, the second pair of feet. Didn't even get a chance to come down. This is an absolute stomping. And you gotta love it. Especially on Lost Week, man. Especially on Lost Week. Oh, man. There's Tech X. We can only take one of these. And Tech X is great, but Crown of Light, though. Crown of Light, though. With the damage, forget about it. Because we quite literally cannot lose the Crown of Light buff. So all it does is just give us, it just gives us double damage for the rest of this run. Bumbo is problematic for a multitude of reasons. This time around, it's because A, we're playing as a Lost, and B, he's going to hoover up a lot of our money, which we need for Keeper Sack, obviously. So the goal is to not let Bumbo get anything. kind of a nasty room. Okay. Alright, there's our Isaac circle. Nope, not quite. Alright, there's our Isaac circle plus a little tail at the end. Alright. And generally speaking, you do not want to be seeing full clears on the Lost, but on a run that's this powerful, it doesn't really matter. Again, if we can rack up some big damage upgrades in here, that'd be great. And yes, I would love even more damage upgrades than what we've got right now. Our full clears are just on fire today. The stuff of legends. How does he do it? An iron bar seems good, but Halo of Flies also seems pretty good. Nice little defense bonus. Not that we probably need Halo of Flies. I hope that we don't, but you know, it's nice to have a little bit of extra defense every now and then. Never know who you might need it against. Absolutely destroyed. Of course we're going to do a victory lap. Victory lap on the Lost Week. 9-3, Foxtrot 6, 4-7, Zulu 7. Oh, man. Here we go. I think Ibalio is good here. Ibalio turns the babies into an Ibalio that is heat-seeking and also still swings the sword. Because, you know, that has to make sense. Makes sense, right? So it still retains all the properties of Ibalio. It just makes it even more hilariouser. Neptunus. I think we go Neptunus here. Let's see how this is going to work. Does this even work with C-section? No. It's just a straight up damage. It's just straight up tears up, I think. I did not mean to pick that up. Oh, we don't actually want Trisagion. I was going to go Cricket's Body there, but I figured that I didn't know if Neptunus worked with C-section, if we can, like, just spit out little babies. Book of Shadows wouldn't be terrible. Book of Shadows, I mean, it gives us even more security. So if we do end up fighting Beastie or go down to fight Mother or fight Delirium, then, you know, we're going to be real happy that we had it. We'll see. I don't know. Let's see where the winds take us, you know? There is our Guppy right there. We got the Gupster. Now things just get stupid. I take Mom's Perfume. Remember, we're gaining stats every time we buy something because of Keeper Sack that we got on the first run. Paperclip, we've got plenty of keys. We fallen. We don't actually need Skinny on Mushroom. And I don't think Bar Soap. Oh no, Bar Soap still is gonna affect us. Another Birthright. I don't think Birthright's gonna do anything. I mean Tech X for sure. This is starting to turn into the King Crown Champion of Lost Runs here. I mean, all we're missing is Sacred Heart now for some truly stupid combos. This is rough. They would take Telepathy for Dummies for Bookworm because we don't want Mr. Mega, we don't want Lil Haunt. There's not really much that first item pedestal could really offer us, and I'm not going to take blind items. That is just suicidal. But yeah, we can just go in the mirror. Probably would behoove ourselves to at least see who the boss is so we can get another item or two. Oh my gosh. Guppy's Tail. Well, we kind of slid into that one, but sure. Guppy's Tail looks good. Mr. Dolly's a range and tears up. There's our maxed out tears again. Ooh, compass. Compass is definitely worth our while. Let's go check out the shop arena while we still have it. Again, chaos is going to make the shops very valuable. Worm Buddy! You know we got to get Worm Buddy. Worm Buddy. Sitting on 77 cents right now. This damage is just sick. It's just ludicrous. Well, it kills our tears rate, but, you know, out with the old, in with the new. We get ourselves quad shot, C-section, Godhead, Tech X, and Spirit Sword. Yeah, that's just going to make more babies quicker. We are a baby-making machine right now. I didn't see Lead Pencil over there. I think for the most part, except for one miss, we've been doing pretty well staying on top of Glitch Crown. Our acquisitions haven't been as sloppy as they have been in the past. Unfortunately, we're not going to get ourselves any secret room item in here because obviously chaos. So we get Necronomicon to finish off Bookworm. Sacrificial Altar. We could get rid of Bumbo, maybe. Sac Altar's worth it here because it gives us two extra item pedestals with Glitch Crown and Chaos. I don't know if I can influence this, but I'm gonna try. Yeah, I didn't do anything. Pick a daddy, but I think another Halo of Flies honestly is fine. Maxing out our orbitals here. Strength card. Again, just looking to get a little bit of extra stats here and there. The Worm Buddy going to work. That's what I like to see, son. Little Bethany. Oh man, Pyro. But Tech won though. Gonna go Tech. Gonna go Tech one. Yeah. Now we're officially in Darth Maul territory. Gotta have those lightsabers. Mark would give us movement speed. Movement speed and damage, which again is going to be amplified by, AWAS. It's not going to be amplified by AWAS, but, it's going to be amplified by, Crown of Light. Black Candle. There's Clutch. Don't see Clutch too often. Excuse me, Straw Man. Gonna need you to need you to move away from the chest real quick. Here we go. Now, we didn't have to get all three buttons. We could have just simply gone to the door and flown over the little destroyed minecart. Obviously, as the Lost, this becomes a giant joke. Excuse me. I've been doing too much talking today. Yeah, we don't have to worry about anything in terms of the Indiana Jones run. We just simply fly over stuff. We can do it. We can do it one-handed. We can do it just looking at the screen, and we can get this done without taking a hit. Hopefully. So again, it's the same principle as any Isaac run. Of course that would happen. You basically just yeet mom and then just keep on going. And don't walk into like bombs and stuff that like will just stick with you. Obviously. There you go. It's the easiest mother run you could possibly have. Oh, yeah. There goes Pile. I don't really want anything there. I thought I was going into the Devil Deal room. Oops. Oh, man. That's just... I mean, when the damage goes off, it just... I mean, what do you do? The game cannot handle the amount of damage that we're causing right now. I think we're gonna have to go up to go left. We're gonna have to go north to go west. Secret room should be north of there. It's pretty obvious. Okay. Reverse Magician card is going to give us a super soul. I think a Holy Light. I mean, 2020 would have given us more babies, but I'm not going to say, like, do we need more babies right now? Because we definitely do. However, I will say that, like, it's not that needed. Sacred Orb. Honestly, I'm going to go with the pack that just gives us more damage, more tiers, although we are maxing tiers, of course, but more damage is fun. Sacred Orb's effectiveness is about to be nothing, so I'm not too worried about it. Growth Hormones would be nice here. Get the Spun Transformation. We are absolutely, positively, utterly destroying this run. I love every minute of it. Having the sprinkler might be okay, but it's not more okay than having the Book of Shadows on a lost run. If our intent is to not get not lose a single life here, then yeah. It does make it kind of difficult seeing where you are when all the babies are spinning at once. Oh my god. Well, now this is probably the King Grand Champion of Lost Runs. I cannot think of a Lost Run being any better than this. The amount of insane items that we've gotten, thanks to Chaos and thanks to Glitch Crown, have been legendary. There is not a single boss in this game that is going to be able to stand up against us. I mean, none. He wants more protector, but whatever. It doesn't even matter. Oh my god. All right. Now it's just getting, a little silly. I mean, you can see the face that I'm doing right now without seeing my face. You know my exact expression that I'm making right now. It's just... Eternal D6, welcome back. Sure, Blood Puppy, why not? Actually, you know what? There is one item that we're missing for making this the ultimate lost run. We all know it. You know it. I know it. We haven't seen her yet. Maybe we'll get lucky and see some item pedestals. I mean, we've got 167 damage. 167 damage as the lost. Granted, it is a victory lap, but still, good load. Good loady. That is a heaping chonker of a damage stat right there. Tech point 5, it's just going to give us even more things to fire. Crystal key, whatever, man. As soon as the first set of babies come out, it's just over. I mean, sure, Rot Gut, I guess, if you want. Station 2, because hell, why not at this point? And yeah, let's just throw out an incubus there just for S's and G's. We needed more babies. We need more projectiles for sure. Just one more for good measure, you know. We're not dealing enough damage. The game isn't as dead as it could possibly be. I mean, this is no much of a war as it is between men versus ants here. This doesn't even count. But man, if you enjoyed this video, if you enjoyed this run and you played these seeds, let me know how much fun you had by clicking the like button and leaving a comment, everyone. I would love to hear it. I mean, what else can you say about this? The ultimate lost run. This is going to be the fastest mother kill that you've ever seen, or maybe not see. She's already dead. The fastest mother kill I've ever seen. Hands down. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. Man, if we can expect that for today, what is Wacky Wednesday going to give us? And as always, thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, everyone. Have a great start to your Tuesday, and I will see you tomorrow here in the Mosh Pit. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Like, thanks to patrons of mine like Kylie Nup, Efrain, Lysidius Dex Ludex, Nate Meldick, Brittany Conyers, and Willow of the Wisps. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.